वन्देहं श्रीगुरो श्रीयुता पदकमलं श्रीगुरं वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातम् सहगण रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं श्राद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णा चैतन्य देवं श्रीराधा कृष्ण पादान सगन ललिता श्री विशाखान्वितां
the present human society is so ungrateful and rascal that they are killing cows. So Krishna comes to punish them, these rascals. On the cows, they are too much troubled by this rascal demand, and Krishna comes. Yadadidahi dharma sabyani bhavati bhari abhuthana dharma sa. These are adharmas. Instead of Goroksha, Goroksha means protection to the cows. Instead of protection to the cows, they are killing the cows. So how you can have perfect society? Cows must be protected. It is so important animal. It is giving you the nectar in food, milk. And from milk, you can save your children, you can save your diseased person. And how it is there? You take the cow's milk and send it or slaughter out. Oh, this is not at all human civilization.
There is only one option. I repeat to you, only one option left to climatologists and scientists, and that is to do the unthinkable and to use livestock, bunched and moving, as a proxy for former herds and predators and mimic nature. There is no other alternative left to mankind. So let's do that. And look at the amazing change in this one, where that gully has completely healed using nothing but livestock mimicking nature.
therefore, Varnasram Dharma is so essential that people remain in Sattva. Therefore, they should be brought into Sattva, that is, establishment of Varnasram Dharma.
We have become totally disconnected with the basis and the pillars of Dharma, which are cows. Dharma begins with the protection of cows. When we cut out, you know, when we become disconnected with cows, as we have, in the cities, living in the cities, means we are disconnected with cows. We no longer look after cows. We no longer see cows. We no longer think about cows. We no longer care about cows. If we no longer care about cows, what's Krishna going to care about us? Isn't it? Krishna is constantly meditating on his cows. Krishna worships every day his cows. Krishna cannot live without cows. How can we manage to live without cows? The Brahminical culture cannot be established without cows. Krishna consciousness cannot be practiced without cows. How are we managing to practice our Krishna consciousness without cows? We must ask ourselves these questions.